To the point where Hazel Bill was comfortable enough to ask me to play drums at the First Christian Church. And that was so cool because no one had ever asked me to play. My mom and dad would ask me to stop and never to play. So I played at First Christian Church. This is the same First Christian Church as whose aisle I knew I had to walk down that morning and give my life to Christ when I was just a kid, and it's the same First Christian Church whose steps I sat on when I had thrown everything that I thought I had away and needed Christ back in my life and gave that life back to Him again. On this altar, I married my best friend. At St. Mary's, as a teenager, I was enthralled with the awe and the wonder of the mystery of the liturgy. And as an adult, when my nephew needed a new heart, they fried an awful lot of fish and showed me and my family theirs. At a community church, I baptized my three daughters. And I heard a barn owl at 3:30 in the morning as I prayed with other friends for a Russian judge to find favor to allow a princess to go home with her parents. And last year, I prayed with my friend Jack to accept Jesus as his Savior a little before he passed away. Jack wasn't much on churches and sanctuaries, but he could handle a movie theater. And so he started showing up and he became my friend. I am saved by the blood of Christ. And I am formed by his church. Chance the Rapper said this: don't believe in kings. Believe in the kingdom. I believe in the church. I believe in the bride of Christ. I believe that the only hope for the dumpster fire hot mess of the world that we live in is found in the proclamation and praises, the grace and the mercy, the healing and the restoration that comes from the power of Christ that emanates from those that he calls his own who make up the church. Not your church, not my church, but his church. And Christ's call is now our call to proclaim the good news to the poor, to the assembly, to proclaim liberty to the captives and recovering the sight of the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. And this broken world needs his church. Because too many outside of it hide behind locked doors of fear and hopelessness. Too many feel that the ship has already sailed and the storms will never stop raging. Too many look at bare covers and are hungry for dreams that are dying, and some are just hungry. But we have something for them. We have the hope of Christ. We have the good news to introduce the broken mess of a world to the one who said he came to save it. And when we introduce those people to him, if the doors are locked out of fear, Christ, he walks through them. If the ship has sailed, he walks on the water. If the storms rage and the waves crash, he calms the sea. And if the covers bear, he takes a school kid's lunch, and through us and in us and with us, he feeds thousands. And they know